How's everyone? So today we're going to be talking about quite a controversial species. It's one that's gone in and out of being predated and not. Up until recently it was predated, now they have opened the season up again. And that is the copper stenbrus, also known as the red stenbrus, or copper, but that gets a bit confusing. Scientific name, Petrus rupestris. Okay. So the copper stenbrus itself, it is an open season now. Well, it is open to be caught. There is a closed season that applies the same time as the shad, so that's 1st October to 30th of November. You may not touch, may not get involved, you may not hook anything like that with the coppers. So obviously if you do catch one, you're not going to know until it gets up to the surface, then you're going to have to unhook it and get it down as safely as possible back to its environment. With the depths that we generally catch bottom fish at, please make sure you have a release mechanism. You guys should know these by now if you're bottom fishermen. When it comes up from the deep water, that pressure drops suddenly and the swim bladder actually expands and pushes the stomach or any of the other organs out through the mouth. That's when you get that big default inflated, either the swim bladder or the stomach pushing out. That can get ruptured by the teeth and all sorts and can cause severe internal bleeding. On a positive side, it is reversible. Not the severe internal bleeding, but the stomach popping out. You get a rather large hook, like a 12-0 Kendall or so like that. You push the Kendall type shape. You push the barb flat. You have a heavy sinker attached to it. And then you're gonna tie your line from your rod onto the bend of the hook, so onto the bend itself. You're gonna hook it into the top lip, drop him back down to right to the bottom, strike, and it'll pull out the lip, and that pressure, because it's now equalized down at that depth, he'll be fine. The stomach will pop back in, everything, he'll swallow it back down, good to go. So that's just make sure, if you are gonna be fishing waters deeper than say 20 meters, just make sure you do have a rod rigged up with that ready to go so you can release fish safely. Back to the show. So, the copper stenbrus, he gets to around about 2 meters in length and about 70 kilos. There are records of bigger fish, rumors of bigger fish, and fish, you know, well over 80 kilos and things like that, but 70 is really sort of the ceiling limit over there. They've done aging on these species. You know, guys get very tired of hearing this. There was a fish of about 1.4 meters length, and they aged it was actually 33 years old. So that shows you how slow growing these fish are. They're very, very slow growing on the reef themselves. They're very important in the whole biological cycle. They're important top predators. We need to look after them. They grow slowly. So if you're gonna keep them, keep your one, you are allowed one. But remember, if you often get them together on the same sort of area, if you're gonna catch another one, it gets taxed by a shark, or you have to put it back down and it does die, that should be counted in your quota, should be. And it's really rather put them back, especially the older versions, the bigger boys, they're much more important set free than they are in your hatch. Now, the copper is a endemic species. We get them from False Bay up to about St. Lucia. The endemic, of course, means that we only get them here. That means if we stuff it up, that's it, the population's gone. There's no resource in Australia, New Zealand, Hong Kong, wherever, that we can get genetic samples for and try and put them back into our stocks. You have, overall, I know we haven't actually discussed this, copper's got quite a large, it's a large, robust fish. They have got very big fins, they're extremely, extremely strong. Their overall appearance is very robust, coppery, sort of reddy to goldy kind of color, depending where you catch them and how alive they are. Once they go dead, they do go more of a silver color, they lose that color quite quickly. But that lively, angry individual has got quite a strong face. It looks like he's got a big, strong jaw, which they do. Very strong jaw. Canines on there properly. I mean, they can injure you if they wanted to, if they get bitten by it, so keep your hands away from the mouth. They are, as I mentioned, generally the apex sort of bony fish predator on the reefs, especially in the Transkei and things like that, your deeper reefs. You get them from 20 meters depth down to about 160, but they're all sort of mixed and matched in between there. Unfortunately, as I say, slow growing, most of them have been wiped out on the closer reefs, and you're only really gonna get them on those deep water reefs. And there, the strong currents sort of protect them from being targeted actively. Otherwise, in terms of their feeding, they're gonna feed on any of your prey fish. So that's everything from soldiers through to mackerel and all of anything in between. Bait for them wise, if you catch a little soldier, obviously legal size, or a little slinger, and you flap that and you drop that down, or you put them down live, that is often a deadly bait for copper. Now, I personally am not the expert in coppers, so while your guys that are going to be commenting in the bottom there can give us a few tips and tricks if they want, we'd always appreciate that. Your spawning wise, they spawn off the Eastern Cape, so that Transkei area, between July to October. So that's when you're going to get your biggest concentrations of them, and that's obviously when they're the most vulnerable. So during that time, guys, please take into account that they are protected by closed season and by very small bag limit of one. And if you do catch your fish, rather move off. Let them carry on their life there and carry on what they're doing. So yeah, only other thing to worry about, we've got the teeth that are quite dangerous because of the strong jaw, they can injure you. And the liver itself is very, very high in vitamin A. That comes from what they eat. So don't eat the liver. The vitamin A, you can get vitamin A poisoning from eating all of it, and it's not a fun thing, it can actually kill you. So the liver itself, rather discard it. Some people do eat them, but yeah, rather get rid of it. And yeah, as you mentioned, close season, same as the shad. And yeah, release them, please. Yeah, the copper's dead, Russ. Cheers, guys.